Thank you. Mr. President, we do fine. This is another milestone, Mr. President.
Please give the President a chance to make his remarks, please.
Ladies and gentlemen, the President will not speak before us today on this landmark. So we are going to take a few questions, not many of them. And the first question in the line is Mari Kepa. Kepa, I want to post this question. And I hope you will be very, very mindful of the time and when your friend is speaking, give him a chance. Mike, please post a question.
Thank you very much. Mr. President, hello and welcome to ELBC Live Online and LBS Radio. You played here before, you came from the slum, and today you have brought this transformation to the people. You have been here and you are here. What does this mean to you as your folks are right here observing what is being done here today?
Well, first of all, glory be to God, and thank God for the many blessings. I'm glad that I have my former coach and one of the greatest players ever came from West Ham, played for the most of 11, Frank Derrick Onakwe, standing beside me. He knew the history of the field. We were just talking that the famous Lamoudet, I was a goalkeeper here, and I took cup from Lamoudet on this field. At that time, the field was this way. But today, we are here for the same kid that I was, 14, 15 years old. That plays on the field to make the field the way it is today. He said, glory be to God. So I'm very happy that the Westman field, and no one thought that it could be developed, it's developed today. Tony Skip. I just want to say again, like I said to Jericho, we want to name the field, and he's a famous footballer in this community. But again, we lost one of the best players, Amado, aka Dubedo, and I asked him if we name the field Dubedo soccer pitch. And it's not him, but see, he's a very honest guy. He said, well, it's no more. It's a legacy. He's one of the best players here. So this soccer field now we call the Amado soccer pitch. So we remember a young friend that left us soon. But I'm very satisfied. Now, the history of West Ham, we all know. we grew up here. You know, I'm from Flower Town, we come here, we spend our entire day on this field. Today is transformed, and I just hope that the people of Westman take care of the field. You know, now they have a factor, they have the field, so it's easy now to repair the field. If the turf is, it'll take maybe 4 to 5 years to be changed, and then they'll be ready to change it. So at least they get a structural field now to enjoy. So I'm very glad, you know, that all of the community that are looking for a sports center, we'll try to do our best. We're going to leave here, and maybe in 2 weeks, we'll be in Clarendon, where I live. We'll go in Dunbury Clarendon Field, and then after Clarendon, we'll go to D2F Field, all of us. It's important, every community in Europe, regarding the fees that children can regulate, and I think it's important for us. So I'm very happy to be what's his friend in Westman.
Mr. President, with this leading construction of fees across Liberia, what does it mean for this footballing world, most especially those kids that are coming up playing football within Liberia?
Well, it's a recreational place. I mean, we grew up in this society, in the pitches that were not given or constructed, and we made it. So that people can be inspired. And this is a way for children to not be adamant. You know, when they come from school, and they find something to do, they get on the pitch and exercise.
With the president,
even people that don't even play soccer can jump on the field for their own health reason.
I'm Thomas Kojo.
A legend of football, you are doing nothing about the Liberia Football Association. What are people saying to them?
Well, if you just inaugurated the Liberia Football Association office, and you get an invisible power, now Clarendon come in, then you get PHP coming, and critics say that I, as a former footballer, I'm not doing football, then they just talk. You know, I don't believe in talk. Like I said to all of you the other day, it's not what they say. They said that I would not do anything anyway. So I'm glad that my fingerprint is everywhere in the society, whether it's sports, whether it's road construction, education, health. You can see, I came here in 5 years, why they have not achieved 171 years all around you. So they can keep talking.
Mr. President, I'm Thomas Kojo Rolak. I work for Freedom Heavy TV. I'm like your best sports journalist. 1996 and 2002, we went to the AFCON with racket pitches. Now we have many pitches on your region as a president. It doesn't mean that the AFCON is close to Liberia in terms of qualification.
Well, we're just discussing it in the car, and I hope that every African president and every African leaders and are listening to me. Liberia is the oldest African independent states. I think it's important that we host our African Cup, and we're going to negotiate. We're going to lobby when the time comes, so we can host it. We are now lobbying for Morocco because of the performance in the World Cup. We are lobbying for them to host. And then we'll go to Morocco to help us to host.
Do you feel ballot about Liberia not going to the AFCON under your region as a president and a footballing president? Do you feel ballot about it?
Well, this is life. I went twice when I was a footballer. So as a president, I still made history. So I don't have a problem because as a technical director of the Liberian national team, I promised Liberia that I'm going to take them to AFCON. And I took them twice.
The last question I have is,
as president, you are building in many stadiums, places you play football. I'm wondering, why not out of these places?
No, you see, I think all of you press, the journalists need to understand our developmental plan. It's across the country. It's not just in Montserrat. We went on a country tour. I spoke to the Liberian people that the hospital will be built in every county, school will be built in every county, and everything that they need will be built, roads will be built in every county. But it's not one day, it's a process. So you need to understand it, be able to communicate that to your people. We have a project to build our country. It will not be one day, it's sequential. And of course, we have to
start from one to the end of our.
When do you extend this in other countries? When you tend to extend this kind of activity?
Well, we have a plan to go to the other countries, and the plan is in place. You can see now. We will finish with Mosorado, and then we'll go to Bong County, we'll go to Lima County, we'll go to Lofa County, we'll go around. And you need to check the list of how many fees we're building across the country. Then you have idea. So those that are responsible with the list, go to the list, go to the office, and get the sheet. Then you know how many of these facilities we're building across the country. Then you'll not be asking this kind of question.
Thank you, Mr. President. Thank you very
much. All right, come on down, His Excellency.
Mr. President, I just want to tell the members of the media that this effort is not just limited to Western and African, but it's going to continue for time to come. Thank you.
Okay, sir.
Jesus.